Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Not Trees podcast. Today I will summarize and review the book. In Moonwalking with Einstein, The Art and Science of Remembering Everything, Joshua Foer takes readers on a fascinating journey through the world of memory. Foer, initially a journalist covering the U.S. Memory Championship, becomes intrigued by the participants' ability to perform extraordinary feats of memory. This curiosity leads him down a path to understand the mechanisms behind memory and how anyone can improve their ability to remember. Through rigorous training, Foer immerses himself in ancient mnemonic techniques, and within a year, astonishingly transforms from a forgetful journalist into the U.S. memory champion. This book is not just a tale of personal triumph, but a compelling exploration of the science and history surrounding human memory. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, The Art of Remembering. Foer delves into the art of remembering, introducing readers to the method of loci, also known as the memory palace technique. This ancient technique, dating back to Roman times, involves visualizing a familiar place and populating it with vivid, unusual images representing the information one wishes to remember. Foer demonstrates how this method can be used to memorize vast amounts of information by creating a vivid and unforgettable mental journey. The effectiveness of the memory palace lies in its leverage of spatial memory and the brain's ability to recall images more readily than words. Through engaging narratives, Foer illustrates how anyone can harness this technique to significantly improve their memory. Secondly, the science of memory. Foer explores the neuroscience behind memory, breaking down complex concepts into understandable explanations. He discusses how memories are formed, encoded, and retrieved by the brain, emphasizing the malleability of memory. The book sheds light on different types of memory, such as procedural and declarative, and how they function. Foer also introduces readers to research on neuroplasticity, which suggests that the brain can reorganize itself and form new neural connections throughout one's life. This scientific foundation helps readers appreciate not only how memory works, but also how it can be enhanced through practice and technique. Thirdly, the journey to becoming a memory champion. Foer's personal journey from a curious journalist to the U.S. memory champion forms a compelling narrative throughout the book. He recounts his year-long training, during which he learns from mentors, tackles challenges, and faces setbacks. This storyline is not just about memorization techniques, but also about perseverance, discipline, and the discovery of one's potential. Foer's transformation exemplifies how, with the right methods and sufficient practice, the limits of memory can be pushed beyond what most people consider possible. His experience serves as an inspiration to readers, proving that exceptional memory capabilities are not solely innate but can be developed. Fourthly, historical context of memory techniques. Foer places mnemonic techniques in a broad historical context, tracing their origins and development over centuries. He examines how memory was valued and cultivated in ancient cultures, and how the advent of written language and later, digital technology changed the way people remember by revisiting the memory feats of figures like Cicero and Simonides. Foer illustrates how the art of memory has evolved, but also how modern society has lost touch with these powerful techniques. This historical perspective enriches the reader's understanding of memory and emphasizes the importance of reviving and applying these age-old methods in today's world. Lastly, the practical applications of improved memory. Foer not only explores memory through the lens of competition and science, but also discusses its practical applications in everyday life. He argues that improving memory goes beyond just memorizing decks of cards or long lists of numbers. It can enhance one's life in profound ways. From learning new languages to remembering names and important details, better memory can lead to improved professional performance, stronger personal relationships, and a more engaged and fulfilling life. Through practical advice and personal anecdotes, Foer makes a compelling case for the wide-ranging benefits of developing a trained memory. In conclusion, Joshua Foer's Moonwalking with Einstein, The Art and Science of Remembering Everything, is an enlightening read for anyone interested in understanding and improving their memory. Whether you are a student looking to excel academically, a professional aiming to sharpen your mental acuity, or simply someone curious about the wonders of the human mind, this book offers valuable insights and practical techniques. Foer's journey from memory novice to champion serves as a powerful testament to the idea that, with the right approach, anyone can unlock the extraordinary capabilities of their memory. Ultimately, Moonwalking with Einstein doesn't just teach readers about memory. It inspires them to reimagine the limits of their own cognitive abilities. If you would like to support Joshua Foer, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.